Wow, thank you all so much for being here tonight. Thank you for attending these awards. Thank you for supporting all of the amazing people here. I want to start by giving a deep thank you to the AQC staff for putting on this event, and thank you to the AQC Advisory Board for selecting me and all of the other great awardees tonight. I also want to give deep appreciations for all of my families here at Stanford. Thank you to the Filipino American Student Union for being my familia and for always being a center of joy and struggle. Thank you to the Asian American Issues Alternative Spring Break for always learning, growing, and freestyle rapping with me. Thank you to the program and CSRE and to all my academic advisors for being the academic home to my political practice. I promise I'll turn in my thesis eventually. And thank you to the Stanford Asian American Activism Committee for always being a place to educate, agitate, and organize. I am so humbly in front of all of you today, not just because of any individual feats, but because I have been deeply cared for by a vibrant community and by a in getting ready for tonight, I was reflecting on how I got to be so deeply invested in this Asian American community and movement, and I wanted to share a little bit of that with you. My freshman year, I was 25 minutes late to my first PASO meeting. On that Sunday, I nervously walked into the AQC, totally ashamed that I was so late. Oh my God, what were they gonna think of me? I frantically ran up the stairs to the couch room, my heart beating quickly in a combination of nervousness and fatigue. The stairs are steep. I rolled open that door, and every single face on that meeting turned around and stared at me. Timmy, Timmy, oh my gosh, yay, come get some ice cream! A couch of posse members, people are actually sitting right here, called me over by name, gave me a bar of Halo-Halo flavored ice cream, and assured me that it was no problem that I was late, they were just happy to see me. This was my first lesson in organizing at Stanford. Since then, I've learned how to build campaigns, raise thousands of dollars, organize effective direct action, and win victories that get us the goods. So many of these lessons, though, have been because of my friends and mentors in the Asian American community. These people have given me the space to take my lived experiences and understand them as being part of larger systems of political power, privilege, and oppression. Understanding that my mother's experience in this country is part of a larger narrative of American imperialism and Filipino migration that still force nearly 6,000 people every day to leave their homes and become overseas workers. To understand that my own ability to go to Stanford as a low-income, queer, gender non-conforming student of color has been because of decades of student organizing from the Chinese clubhouse to taking back the mic, to takeovers, to hunger strikes, and now to asking who's teaching us. To thinking about what's going on even today as hunger strikers are at San Francisco State University and standing outside of the San Francisco Police Department demanding justice for their campuses and for their bodies, for the black and brown communities in our local areas. Understanding these things and hearing these things for the first time, my experience and identity wasn't just a question. It was a statement. A statement of resistance. My own ability to even live counteracted institutions of white supremacy, of patriarchy, of capitalism that told me that I shouldn't even be alive, let alone be thriving. Grace Lee Boggs, in her last decades of life as an activist and as a philosopher, talked about the importance of understanding what it means to be a human in the 21st century. In the midst of environmental degradation, of rampant police brutality, of global capitalism, and of violence against non-normative bodies, she encouraged us to turn inward and question how we can be more with each other. She said, "These are the times to grow ourselves. Each of us is called upon to embrace the conviction that despite the powers and principalities bent on commodifying all of our human relationships, we have the power within us to create a world anew. The Asian American community at Stanford introduced me to the Asian American movement, introduced me to how I and we are agents in history, and how I and we can be a shaper of our collective futures. We look back at the past to better conceptualize how we can move forward together, how we can stay grounded in values of abundance, of compassion, and interdependence, and it's no coincidence that so many speakers tonight have spoken to those same values. And, you know, honestly, I don't know what the future holds. I don't know how we will win. And sometimes it seems so, so hard and so, so far away. But right now, I'm thankful for a community who has given me the space to create those worlds right where we are and create those realities as we are also still fighting to get free. I am thankful for all of you here and thankful to be in this movement with you. And the thing that I want to leave you with in this moment is how I've learned to end all meetings with an act of solidarity, with an act of love, and with an act of moving on to the next thing. So if you're familiar with this, please go ahead and do it with me. It's called Isang Baksa.